Yeah, here we will start with one of the hybrid application framework, which is Ionic, which gives a lot of flexibility to build mobile application with a single code base, or also it gives flexibility to build a PWA, progressive web apps, from a single code base. So this framework is quite known and quite popular in today's market. It gives two options to build the mobile applications on different platforms like Android, iOS, Windows, BlackBerry, on different platforms by two native things, like one is Cordova and one is its own developed capacitor. So today I'm going to tell you like about the basic setup of the Ionic project when you start working with the sample project, how you should start. Some important points I will cover here. I have mostly worked with Angular and bit in React also, in React framework also. So here we will proceed with this Ionic doc which they have shared. Okay. Yeah, so actually this dashboard is for capacitor. Here you will be asked for subscription or something, so I have not subscribed the subscription till now because I used to develop by my own. So here we'll proceed with this. There's three or four, dependencies over here. React, you can start with React also, Ionic plus React, and you can start with Ionic plus Angular, you can start with simply JavaScript, and you can start with Vue.js. So this this framework has quite expanded its reach with React recently and with Vue.js recently, but first it was with Angular only. So we'll go for first with environment setup. I will show you one of my sample code base. You can take a pull from there and you can start working with that. With basic changes, there you will find some path resolver and something. You can start with that, but first I will go with the environment setup. So the two major dependency is Node and npm. Once you have to install the Node. Second thing is to install the Ionic as a global, which is CLI install, CLI. So you have to install like npm install minus this CLI. If it's already installed, then first you have to uninstall it and you have to reinstall it if you are using earlier version of the Ionic. So once this is installed, so you can simply start with an application from command line, because CLI is already installed, command line is already installed. So you can start with Ionic start, some app name, and whatever you want. You want to start a blank project, or you want to start with side menu, or you want to start with tabs. So there are three most common templates available here: blank starter, tabs starter, and side menu starter. So you can start with these, and once you created a new project with Ionic, you have to just go to project directory. It will create one folder with your project name, and you just cd to go to that project named folder and just run Ionic serve. This is a basic setup. It will run the Ionic service over port 8100. Till my knowledge, by default it will run on 8100. So your package is ready. Now it's come to integrating the native things. So you have to install the Cordova if you are going to build for iOS or Android or Windows or BlackBerry something. So you have to use the Cordova version, Cordova dependency, to start building native apps. Here they have expanded the feature with different packages like Angular, React, Vue. So if you want to start with Angular plus Ionic, then you have to install this Ionic Angular. Or if you start with React, then you have to install the Ionic React, and same for Vue also. So this is one of so you can start with these three JS, and these three have different syntaxes and all, and the process. So build your, here is one next step, is build your first application. So if you are going to start with Angular, then first you have to install the Angular CLI is already installed. You have to install the native run and Cordova RES. These are two. This, suppose you are going, yeah, here it's given like Ionic Start Photo Gallery. Photo Gallery is the project name. And recently I said like you can start with three blank three templates, that tab, side menu and blank. So it's here it's starting with tabs, and if you don't pass any next option in the next column, it will ask you for the type, which type of project you are going to start with. Type will be Angular, React, Vue or JavaScript. So you can pass here, and next is capacitor. Next, if you pass the capacitor, it will start with capacitor, like it will generate the configuration file for capacitor and all. If you don't pass this, it will not generate anything. It will generate simply Ionic plus Angular project. So this is the basic setup. Here it's shown in doc. I will also show you in the template I have created. Now coming to next thing is to build for natives. So here you can see Android development. They have given the guide to develop. The guide seems self-elaborative. The guide covers how to run the debug and debug Ionic apps on Android emulator and devices in Capacitor and Cordova. So I first will cover up the Cordova section. So it's coming in, this Cordova is open source, and it's a platform which gives the views created by HTML, CSS and Java to interact with the natives, Android or iOS natives. So after a long search, I found my APT, which was created a very long time back. So here it few introduction has been given, what is a hybrid application, like when we go for React Native or Ionic. These all are hybrid platform to have a single code base and build for multiple platforms. So it's like first is HTML5 detects like native directly access to native APIs, familiar web dev environment, and develop a single code base. Different platforms like Android, iOS, web, Windows, it's easy to learn and develop. This is some basic web-powered native proficient for each platform. Entirely separate code base. Time consuming. About brief about native, like when you have to build an app for Android and iOS both. So when we go for native, we need to maintain two code bases, and for Android is in Java, and for iOS in Objective-C. So this will be resolved by this hybrid mobile applications. hybrid mobile application code base, time consuming and expensive development, more platform, more problems, and language centric. This language centric, like this will be done in Java, and this will be done in Objective-C. So like that. So what is Ionic? First of all, it's built on an Angular, React, CSS, like that. This document is too old. It was prepared in 2018, I think. Uses Cordova, PhoneGap to build, running the, deploying the mobile application. Contains a lot of CSS, JS component, native like performance, and beautifully designed. And why we should go native focused, performance obsessed, hardware accelerated animations, minimal DOM manipulations, resume 3, removes 300 ms stop delay, plain old CSS, CSS 80% reusable, makes sense, performance toolkit, blue paste CSS, etc. So prerequisites, what are the dependencies I mentioned in the beginning? So dependency first will be basic knowledge of, if you are going to start, you need to have a basic knowledge of JavaScript, basic knowledge of Angular or React or whatever framework you are going to use in that, and basic knowledge of Cordova. Mostly in when you are going to interact with native, most of the plugins are available on npm or GitHub. You can get reference from their doc how to use that, how they are going to interact with JavaScript and native. So you can start with that. This is a basic flow, like how it works. This will be the Cordova plugins. Everything will be communicated through. Everything will be communicating through the Cordova, that it will create a native bridge between the device and your code. So moving forward, what are the environment setup needed? So first of all, you have to install the npm package, which is Node, and I have given the example here, like when you are going to install on which platform. For Windows, download the exe file and install. For Linux based, sudo apt update, sudo apt get installed Node.js. You have to just simply run this. For Ionic, if already installed, so you need to install the Ionic. So you have to once Node.js and npm is installed, so you have to run the npm ionic npm install minus g ionic to install Ionic especially. And for Cordova, you have to run npm install minus g Cordova. It will install the Cordova, which is a native bridge. Now coming to Cordova and Android SDK setup, so you can be ready for Android build. Install Cordova by npm and Android SDK to build the app. Before installing Android SDK, make sure Java installed and set in environment path, because Android will search for your Java path, and make sure to install the Java version is 1.8 before installing the Android Studio. So download an Android Studio stable version from their portal and try to install that. Next, coming to building your first app, start your first app by running command either in command prompt or internal Ionic start my app tabs or blank something. Now we have to add one more flag here, something is option like type, which type of framework you are going to use, either a React, Vue or Angular. So it will download a default template from Git along with the specified theme like blank tabs and side menu. If you want to just run the app without any change, run Ionic serve internal under a project directory, and here you are ready to go, and you can view the page in browser, any browser, with localhost:8100 port. Now coming to additional platform, adding platform and running the app on physical devices. First you have to add the, your environment is already set up with Cordova and all. So first you have to add the platform, on which platform you are going to run the device, run the app. So here is the command, like on a Cordova platform add, you can add either Android, iOS, Windows. Once this is added, so you can directly go and run this Ioniq Cordova build platform, iOS, Android or Windows. This will build one APK, or for iOS it will build one IPA, or for Windows it will build one exe file. So that can be run on different devices depending on the their platform. What are things you have to know when you are going for a hybrid application development? Basic knowledge of HTML5, JavaScript, or the basic knowledge of framework which will be used in that project, and some basic UI components, and some basic knowledge of the native plugins which will be used, like splash screen and all. So here in document I will come back again for Android Studio installation. Here you can see they have given in the doc developing for Android how to set up the path, and how to add emulator, how to export the path in command line, and how to create a virtual device, how to create a virtual device which we call as emulator, and how to set up Cordova. These all things are listed here. So now I will go with my template what I have designed. So I will come here and I will show you the native things which you will need in your project development. So here I have designed one Ioniq template. It is available on gitlab.com. I will share the link, this link in description. I used to update this sometime when it needs an update. I used to update it here. So when you set up a basic environment, it will look like this. It will consist E2E, that is for testing, SRC, gitignore is added for ignoring some files and all. This file is added by me. Readme, it will come. Angular JSON, browser list, Ioniq configuration, kernel config js, package lock. This will be generated after npm install. Package JSON, ts app config, tslint, ts config, ts config specification JSON, tslint. This lint is a very important part of this of any Ioniq project. This is an important part to have a quality code check. We'll cover this tslint part in some other video. So you can see the demo here. So you can see the demo here. When you click this, it will open up one page. This is hosted somewhere. You observe here, like when I just hit this URL, it redirects me to dashboard home. So this is a sample page given here. So this is being built by this Git CIML, which is having a bit of code to deploy this, like image node pin npm deployed, it installing the Angular CLI, installing Ioniq CLI, then installing the packages, and it's adding a npm angular pwa progressive web app, and it's building this pwa, and it's publishing in this folder. So it's self-hosted. Whenever I will make a commit in this project, it will auto build the things, and it will release one version to this URL, whatever changes will be there. So now I will go with first packet.json. So when you will start with this template, if you take this template, so here you have to change few things, like what will be the your application name, version you can mention by your author name, who is going to write the application, this will change. What is the home page of that application, like any application which is being enrolled in market will have a web page and something that will be listed here. These are the basic changes for your project. And one is description. You can list out, like you can give the a basic description about your app. Now coming back to the project directory, here you already set up. Till now there is no Android or iOS configuration given here, nothing has been given here, no config file is given here. So I will directly go in SRC. You will see few files and few folders are there: app, assets, environments, theme, and global CSS index. Whenever you will run Ionic project or Angular project, first the request will hit on this index.html. So you have to change here the title, which will be your app name, and rest of the things will remain as it is. If you wish, you can change your fab icon about for your project, like you will have some logo and all, you can change it. First request will come here, and it will have a body like app root. This is a component called like HTML selector, HTML selector. So this will be routed to app, and it will go to the app.component. First request will come to app.component. It will find this selector, like app root is here. Then it will start loading, start executing this method and files. So first of all, here in constructor of this method, I am initializing the app. So what is the first is asking for a platform is ready. Then it's saying status bar set default and hide the splash screen and check for the network. And if the platform is Cordova, so the network true. And this is one platform pause or platform resume. So this page is loaded, this executed. But what happened? This is a selector. This is selector and with template URL and style URL. So now coming to template of this page. Here is the template. Yeah. So here is the template. It is asked for Ionic router outlet. So it will search for the routes. Where are the routes? Where are routes going? So it will come to this. First of all, it will inject here, it will go to app.module, because that the app root is being loaded here. First module app.component, that is the root. So once it says like I have a router outlet, so it will go to read the router strategies or whatever router module, app routing module has been defined. So it will go here, app dot routing module, and in app dot routing module it will search which is the default one where I have to go. So when you see this app dot routing module, you will see that routing constant path redirect to dashboard. So when you see this, when I remove this one and just I hit the URL, it first redirect to dashboard and then it redirected to home. So it first redirect. If the path is empty, if I given only the URL, there nothing any path given, so it will first redirect to dashboard and path matches. Actually it's empty path, so it will redirect to dashboard with full control. And here is the path given from where it how it will load the dashboard. Dashboard is loaded as load children, and the page is given as for page model here. So now coming back to app, I will go to pages because dashboard is under page. I will come here. So here I will find that it will first hit at this dashboard module, because in page, if I duplicate it, I can explain in better way. If I duplicate it and go to app routing component, app routing module, here you will see like first it's matching the full path and redirecting to dashboard. Now dashboard is redirected, so I have to put here where is dashboard and from where it will load. So it's under pages, dashboard module. So first of all, dashboard module will hit here, dashboard module. When dashboard module will be hit, this is a component less routing. This is not actual component. Dashboard is not actual component. That is component less. It is being used as a router. So first of all, it will come. It will search for routing module for childs. So it will go to the routes. It will search which path I have to go. So it will redirect empty. There is nothing after the dashboard. There is nothing given. So it will directly redirect to home. But where is home? So home path is as a children. It's under home folder and home. This is a component less routing. So under pages, go to dashboard. It will come here home. So again in home dot module there it's given, so it will hit this home dot module, and when home dot module will be hit, it will go for routing module for child. So it will go to write a route, and it will say the path is same, but this is a component and the address is home page. So this home page will be loaded. So this home page, it will be loaded. Then it will come to this home page.ts file. It will ask for selector. It will ask for template URL. It will ask for style URL, and it will just load the home. This is a basic flow which I have created in a structured way. Like here you can see, I have kept the component separate, guards separate. Pages as separate, pipes, custom pipe you can write or not, is separate, and services as separate. So in services you can have your own services for APIs call, and for the native interaction you can have your own service calls right there, like that. So in app I have mentioned, you will see in guards I have just created a dummy here, auth guard. In component you will see like action button, footer, header, image slide, inline info, inline like single line info, you can pass the input and it will print side menu. So again going to pages, you already seen pages are, if I go here and say onboarding, if I click onboarding, it will redirect me to login page, because onboarding the default route is on login. And if I sign up, see if it exists. Yeah, it exists. And if I go for one more page, will be here. So account, if I come here on account, it should redirect to my profile and something. Yeah, it's redirected to my profile and something. So this is the basic setup, and you can clone this app and you can start working. So I will guide you here how you will generate the page, import the page. And most importantly, you have seen this, you are using dot dot slash dot dot slash dot dot pages. You use relative paths, but here I am not using the relative paths. I am using alias to import the page, import the service, import whatever custom things I will create here, I will import by alias. So importing pages, how I am going to import is from pages, page folder, what is that, is dashboard or something home, and page.component I am going to import like that, something this. Updating routing module in router, something parts, load child, like this I will add it. Importing component in same way like pages, I will resolve with component folder. Here for services, I will resolve with service folder and the service name dot service. Importing guards in same way, importing environment. When you import environment, if you are not resolving, then if you are not resolving the paths and not using alias and you import the environment, then you can see here in environment there's two types of environment, environment dot prod dot ts and environment. So by default when you import, this will be imported, this will be imported. But suppose I am using 2, 3, 4 in types of environment like production, development, staging. So in that case, always wherever you are importing the environment, you have to change the file name of import, like production, import like staging, import the development environment. To overcome, we need to use the alias import, so it will resolve the whole whatever configuration is given in the Anik run, it will try to import the same with replacement. So now generating the things with a specific folder. So first of all, if I going to generate a page, generate page, I want that new generated page to have in pages folder. So I will give here pages slash page name. It will put the newly generated page under this folder, pages under this folder, and whatever page name I will give, it will come here. Again is generating component. So component in same way I am using generating guards. I am same way using to have a structured way, like this is component, this is a model folder, this is a service folder. So there should not be any missing. Some of the given rules here, or rules not follow here, like you must follow for spacing and some auto spacing and some whatever you follow, for naming convention you follow camel case or something else, it's up to you. But I have given here some suggestions, you can use that. Now coming using valid names, now coming to running and performing builds, I have already given you can specify the port. If you just run Ionic serve, it will serve on 8100 port. If you specify the port, it will run on your specified port. Now adding platform, I have given the same command I shown you there. And to add the plugin here, you have to use like that. All the things here I have given for your convenience. Now coming to building or debugging the app, if you just run Ionic Cordova build, it will build a debug version of the application. And if you want to run on device or emulator, if you want to run on device, don't pass this device flag, it will by default run on emulator. If you pass this device, it will search for the device which is connected with the USB and it will try to run on the device. So now building for production, when you are going to build for production, then your Angular should switch from development to prod version. So that's why we need to use your prod flag. If you're going to release, this will do some cleaning. And source map we mostly use for error tracking, which with there's some tool like Sentry, which which catch the production bugs and all. So source map is needed for Sentry, so we use source map to generate the source map, and that can be uploaded on the Sentry to have a log tracking. Now coming back to Alize, which is defined here in tsconfig file. Tsconfig file, by default when you start a new project, these options will come, these options will be given. So here I am using Alize to resolve the paths instead of using ./../.sx or all. So I have used here Alize. Just I will write at the right pages and it will resolve the full page path. So I have given here, so my src, first base URL I have changed here, my src is ./src. Now once of all my src is this one, src, by default it will remain as dot, that means it will resolve here, resolve full. So if I put my base URL is src, because my app is running from here, so my base URL is src. So when you put the base RC, base URL as src, and you write at the right pages, and here you have to pass in array what you want to resolve. So I am resolving my base URL is src /app/pages. So it will resolve this array will resolve here. I am putting as a star, so it will resolve star app src /app/pages and /whatever pages under there, it will resolve the paths for all. So I have resolved here paths for assets, pages, pipes, environment, services, even theme, component, guards, and for app also. So this reduces the relative path issue when you are using it in complex project and you are having some different kind of directory structure and using ../.. That is too confusing sometimes. So I have used this to make it easy to import and to have a clean code base like that. Thank you for watching. Hope you will like this video. Please subscribe my channel for further updates. Thank you.